Hello friends, in this video I want to show you how I solved a pretty tricky TPMS error using one of the most useful universal diagnostic tools. Its main function is tire pressure monitoring system diagnostics and fix, but this tool can do much more than just OBD sensor relearn or pressure sensor cloning. You can also read and clear travel codes, view live data to help you fix issues on your car, check your car keys radio frequency, perform many maintenance functions and much more. It's extremely versatile, you can use it on all kinds of vehicles from a basic Dacia all the way to modern electric cars. It runs on a fast and powerful operating system that gives you access to a wide range of apps and features, and even after months of using it, I still haven't managed to explore them all. Let's get started, as always, with a quick unboxing. In this box, I received for testing the Udiag X20 professional diagnostic tool made by a well-known company in the automotive industry. You can find more details on their official website, I'll leave a link in the video description. Let's quickly see what's inside so I don't bore you. The tool is well protected inside a durable carrying case with a nice logo on it. Inside, we've got several adapters for different power sockets around the world. We have an OBD Bluetooth connector with a built-in LED flashlight, really handy when trying to find the OBD port under the dashboard, especially at night. I also received a universal TPMS pressure sensor, which turned out to be perfect for solving the issue I'll show you later. Udiag also sells these sensors separately. Also, there's a USB-C to USB-C charging cable plus an adapter to USB-A if you need it. Of course, the most important item is the main interface. On the back, it has a 5-megapixel camera, super useful if you want to send photos directly from the device. I really like that it operates between minus 10 and plus 60 degrees Celsius, so it's built to last even in tough workshop conditions. On the right side, you've got the USB-C charging port and the power button. Also, if you don't like the rubber case, you can easily remove it. There's also a quick start guide inside. The coolest part is that the software itself gives you step-by-step guided procedures for many built-in functions, making it really beginner-friendly. Since it's an Android tablet, I even managed to install AnyDesk to mirror the screen to a larger tablet. You can install any app you like, it has a file manager, so all you need to do is copy the installation file via the included data cable. Here's the main menu. I won't go through every single function now because that would make the video too long. Now, since this is also a tutorial, let's get straight to the real issue I solved right after receiving this tool. And trust me, it was exactly what I needed. This is a 2017 Dacia Duster, my dad's workhorse for farm use, so don't mind the dirt inside and out. He's been driving for over a year with this annoying TPMS warning because in our town, no one had the proper TPMS diagnostic equipment. Let's see what's going on with the TPMS system first. When I ran the TPMS diagnosis, I found error on wheel 1 and 2, but that didn't help much yet. So I opened the help menu and I got two different relearn methods. Then I use the trigger function to identify each pressure sensor individually. You need to hold the top right corner of the tool close to the valve stem. I tried to trigger the front left sensor and got nothing. Then on the rear left, I detected one. Rear right, nothing again. And front right, also nothing. At this point, I suspected that at least one sensor was dead and maybe the ECU had blocked communication with the others until the system was reinitialized. Eventually, I manually entered the stored sensor IDs from the ECU. This allowed me to trigger all sensors except the rear right, which was completely dead, most likely due to a flat internal battery. Since Udiag also sent me a universal replacement sensor, I could now test the manual writing and cloning function. It doesn't matter which wheel I test it on because I'll have to redo the relearn procedure anyway after replacing the faulty sensor. First I went to TPMS manual create. Then I typed the ID of the universal sensor. You can find that ID using sensor info. Then you activate programming and in a few seconds it's all done. If the original sensor were still functional, I could have cloned it directly. Next, I went to a tire shop to replace the original sensor with the universal one. After performing the relearn procedure indicated in the help menu, the TPMS problem was fully fixed. We also had another issue with the airbag system, so it was the perfect time to test DTC reading. That's something almost any scan tool can do, but I wanted to see if it fully supports Dacia Duster. And yes, it worked perfectly. This fault usually means there's a broken connection in the driver's airbag wiring, most often caused by a faulty clock spring or a loose or oxidized connector under the steering wheel. We'll make a full tutorial about fixing that soon. Let me now show you how fast the tool can trigger sensors with good batteries, but this time on a Toyota BZ4X. The car is fully supported and as you can see, we got almost instant activation. Let's check all sensors. If the TPMS system is more complex like on this car, you get access to a lot of information using this tool. Also, the values read by the X20 are more precise than the ones in the ECU. Let's do a quick recap. The Udiag X20 works with a huge range of vehicles, both for TPMS functions and DTC scan and fix, from older cars to modern ones. It includes all the essential maintenance functions. It keeps a detailed history of reports, supports multiple languages. It offers tons of customization options. And the best part, you can use it like a regular Android tablet to search online for DTC solutions or even watch YouTube videos when you're taking a break. And I know the perfect YouTube channel that will help you save money with tutorials and honest reviews. So don't waste any time, hit that subscribe button, give this video a like and leave a comment below because I've got a lot more cool products to review and some exclusive discounts for you. Until next time, take care and bye-bye.